In lesson 2.6, we will be talking about various AIML components. So, if we look at the various ingredients of AIML, AIML basically comprises of a data, a model, and a compute services. So, when we talk about data, data may be a structured data or it may be unstructured data. From the last so many years, we used to have only structured data. Structured data, when we talk about structured data, it is data in the relational format, that is, we talk about the text data that was stored in the form of relational databases in our Oracle databases or in MySQL. So it used to be structured, it mostly comprises of text only. But with the advent of social media, we are getting unstructured data also to analyze, and this data comprises of images, audios, videos, and obviously text is always there. Now, once we have got this data stored with us, we need to model this data. This data modeling can be done in the form of bar charts, pie charts, or we may train various AIML models also. Like in case of classification, we may be able to see particular decision trees will be there. So we need to model this data also using some AIML techniques. And then we'll need computing services also. Computing services, they basically require certain resources for processing the data, training machines, learning models, and making predictions. We will require compute services also. So we will require these three services from Amazon AWS. First one is data, second one is model, and third one is compute. So starting with the data services, when it comes to data, Amazon provides us with the S3 bucket. S3 bucket is a simple storage service of Amazon. This storage service allows enterprises and individuals to store and protect any amount of data. This particular bucket is extremely durable. We can say it is 99.9999% durable, and availability is also good, 99.9% available, which is best in the available in the industry. And it provides us various enhanced features also, like scalability. You can store infinite amount of data in S3 buckets. And then it supports versioning control also. As we have seen, data is available 99.99% of the times. Data is secure also because data is stored, always stored in the encrypted form, and obviously it provides us with a good performance. This S3 buckets allows customers to store data in buckets or directories. You will get a feel just like your computer system has folders. So we'll be storing data in the same way in the buckets also. And each of these buckets has a global universal unique name. That means you need to provide a unique name to each of these buckets. And as I have told you, we can store infinite amount of data in a bucket. And in each object can contain up to 5 TB of data. So S3 allows anyone to collect, store, and analyze the data from anywhere and in any amount. So with S3, you can obviously with S3 you have stored data on your data on the internet, so you can collect it, store it, and analyze from any place in the world. And to ensure the reliability, AWS stores your data in 3 different availability zones, so data is protected also, and data is encrypted also in case of S3. So now we will see how much free space we get in S3. Here we get a 5 GB of standard storage, that is free. It is free for 12 months, and 20,000 GET requests are free and 2,000 PUT requests are free. For educational purpose, this much is sufficient. So we will create a Amazon S3 bucket now. So for creating a S3 bucket, just click on services and click S3 here. If you cannot locate S3 here, just scroll down. You will see here storage. In storage, you will see various storage options that are available. One is AWS Backup, EFS, AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery, FSx, S3, S3 Glacier, and Storage Gateway. So out of this, we are interested in S3, Scalable Storage in Cloud. Just click on that. You will see this screen, and then click on Create Bucket. So first of all, you need to select the region. So currently, I'm selecting the Mumbai region. And then give it a bucket name. Bucket name can be any identifier of your choice. So currently I'm and it has to be unique globally. So I'm giving it name my first bucket. Then ACLS disabled. All objects in this bucket are owned by this account. So we need to just keep the defaults. So all the objects that are created in this bucket will be accessed by this particular account only. By default, public access is disabled. Bucket versioning, I'm disabling it right now. I'm just keeping all the default options. Then encryption again, S3 server side encryption with Amazon S3 managed keys. I'm keeping that on. Bucket key again, it is enabled. So I'll just click on create bucket. I'm not able to create a bucket since this particular name already exists. So I'll give this bucket a different name. So I'll give it MG first bucket. I'm not able to get this name also. So I'll just put some letters so I can get this name. MG first bucket 1404. I'll keep this name and I'll click on create bucket. So my bucket is created. Once we have created this bucket, we will upload certain files in this and we'll try to access it. We will be using these S3 buckets while we are creating an AIML project in our S3. So for uploading a file, just select the bucket, click on it, select upload, click on add files. Here I have selected this particular file, click on open and then click on upload. Now this particular object has been uploaded over here. So we'll go to the bucket. We can see in this bucket I have got only this particular file. Now I'll try to access it. Click on the file name. This information is about the file. We will try to access this particular file by using this particular URL. See here, we cannot access it since the public access is denied to it. So just go back. We need to set up the ACL for this particular bucket. So go back to the bucket. Click on permissions. Here, public access is off. So we will click on edit. Here this was by default, this was off. So we will uncheck it and click on save changes and type here confirm. Now we can see here ACL, this particular ACL, that is access control list, is deactivated. We can see check here from the options bucket owner. Since we are the bucket owner, I am the bucket owner, so I have got write and read access. But for the public access there is a dash, so public access is not there. So what we have to do, click on the object ownership. ACLs are default, ACLs by default are disabled as we have done them while creating this bucket. So we will click on ACL enabled and I acknowledge that ACL will be restored. Just check on this option, click on save changes. Now see here, this ACL list which was deactivated, now this is activated. Now click on edit, then provide public access to it. Then click on save changes. Before that, check this box. I understand the effects of these changes on my object and bucket since we are providing the public access to this particular file. Now once again, go to the objects. Click on the object name. See here, we are not still able to access this particular object publicly. So once again, go back. Go back to the buckets, select the bucket name, go to the object, Click on permissions. Say here we need to select the ACL permissions for this particular object also. Then click on edit. Then provide public access for this particular object also. Check, I understand the effects of these changes on the object. Save changes. Now click on the object URL. See here, we are able to access it publicly. So for providing the public access to a particular object, we need to change two things. One thing is ACL permissions should be enabled for the bucket, and then ACL permissions for reading the object should be enabled for that particular object also. So once again, go back. We don't want anyone to publicly access our URL. So once again, go back to the permissions. Click on edit. Uncheck these two options. Click on save changes. And for the bucket also, we need to disable ACL permissions. So for bucket, again, permissions. Go to the ACL list. Uncheck both the options. Click on save changes and we are done. So we have created a bucket with the name MG first bucket, and we have uploaded one object in it, one particular file. We have enabled the public access for that particular object, and after that we disabled it once again. So that is how we are going to create a S3 bucket. In the next chapter, we will see how we can create an EC2 instance.